Feeling blue without you. Give me one more chance. Give me one more dance.
Last one, I swear. I had to film all of these in a row just because this upcoming week is really, really busy and I don't have time, and I need to get these up before everything happens. I have a surgery coming up and a few other things that are just gonna make things a little impossible between now and the end of the month to squeeze things in, since things are arriving so late. So please bear with me. I'm sorry that you had to see the same makeup look and the same clothes throughout like 3 or 4 videos, but I promise you, it's all good stuff. Look at how pretty. And it's yellow. This is actually just a random mystery glam bag that they put out in the glam shopping store. I don't actually know what's in here. I just took it out of the thing. Cost $14, like all the other mystery bags from previous months do. So let's get in here and take a peek what's in here. First thing in here is a double-ended eye brush from Farrah. Farrah seems to be a really popular brand for Ipsy. Although it's got a really pretty holographic handle. The ends are soft. One I believe is a packer brush and the other is like a blender shader brush, which is okay. I'll probably keep that and use that. Once again, can never have too many brushes. Next in here is, this is by Kaleidoscope Cosmetics. I don't believe I have anything from these people. This is a skin blush. Okay. Oh, that's cute. Pretty minimalistic packaging. I kind of like that, honestly. And it is a satin blush. It is a really pretty color. It'll actually go perfect for me. The weird thing is that it's a shimmery blush. Almost like an eyeshadow more than a blush, but I guess it could be used either way. It's even got this cute little mirror built into the lid. You know what? So cute. Definitely cute. Oh. I didn't do that. I'm so sorry. This is by Steve Laurent. I actually had one of these and I passed it to my sister. I bought it in a flash sale. With an over highlighter, because I wanted the over highlighter because it wasn't a shade I didn't have yet. This is a loose powder for eyeshadow in the color rose gold. It's in this cute little shimmer powder thing. I don't like loose powders, so I will probably give this to my sister so she can have a backup. I just don't do loose powders and stuff. Trust me, when it comes to me, it could everywhere. What's this next in the bag? Oh, it's another black eyeliner. Thanks, Ipsy. Like I needed another one. This is by Aurora. Intensely precise eyeliner in the color Espresso. But I'm pretty sure Espresso just means black. Nope, it means brown, and that sucker spreads. So, very liquidy, definitely not for me. That'll probably go to my sister, too. Next in here is a, looks like a lipstick. Yep, liquid lipstick, it says on it, by Fluid. Let's see if I can open this. I mean, it's a pretty color, but I have so many colors like that, and it just seems like really, really chunky. I have a feeling that this would dry really fast, but flake off really, really bad. So I'm gonna give that to my sister and she can decide if she likes that as well or not. Ooh, and last in here is one of my favorite. favorite things from one of my other previous bags I have. This is a lip pencil from Pop Color. And it says pout on point in the color of Risque Rose. Honestly, I think the other one I have is Risque Rose as well. If not, it is a very, very similar shade to this, and I'm actually wearing it now. Let's open up this bag and see, shall we? Oof, I love the metal packaging on it. I really, really do. Honestly, yeah, I honestly think this is the same color I already have. But I'm not going to be mad at it because I could totally use a backup. I love it. I can totally use a backup of this. So you know what? Hells yeah, ain't even mad. And for $14, not a bad bag. Honestly, I was expecting more skincare samples and stuff like my last one. The last mystery one I bought is mainly skincare samples, hand cream. It's like, and it has nothing to do with what I want or what I like. And you know what? I am 100% happy with what came in this bag. There is only one thing I'm really iffy on, and this is beautiful. It's just personal preference that I won't use it, and there's nothing wrong with it. So honestly, 4 out of 5 items again, Ipsy wins. Good going, especially for $14. If you guys actually like this little bag and the items that came in it, it is actually still available in the Ipsy store to buy. So I will put that link down below so you can go shopping for one if you want. But I'd hurry up because they do sell out pretty fast. So that's it, you guys. That's pretty much it for July at the moment that I have for you. That'll probably be the last video for a while, just because everything else I have, I'm waiting on. I haven't gotten either of my BoxyCharm premiums. I haven't even got shipping information for them yet. I haven't gotten updates on my other regular BoxyCharm that I get, because I get 2 of each. Nothing from those either. And I also have another Ipsy bag that's supposed to be here, but it's not here. No tracking for that either. So I mean, I guess we'll see. Actually, you know, I hope so. But who knows? With the way shipping is these days, thanks to good old COVID, you know, no one's really having any good luck. So there's that. So you guys have a good night, good morning, whatever it is to you, and I will see you later. You guys stay safe and stay healthy. Oh, don't forget, stay yourself and stay beautiful too. Bye.
Feeling blue without you. Give me one more chance, give me one more dance.